It's amazing how you can go through life and set things as your purpose and begin to pursue things, wanting Jesus to hold number one spot, but how quickly you can begin to form an idol. For example, there's a ton of people here, all of us to a certain degree, who want to control our worlds. We want to control things, how people respond to us, control the money, control relationships, control family, control. We think that we can control this world. And as Solomon gets into Ecclesiastes and he starts talking about this, he says it's like grasping the wind, trying to control all of the things that go on in your life. He says, you can't control them. You have no idea. Eternity is in the hearts of men, but you don't know where things start and where things end and what God's plan is and what other people are going to do in your life that you can't control. So because you can't control people, you can't control your neighbors, you can't control your spouse, you can't control your kids, you can't control your parents, you can't control your in-laws, outlaws, can't control anybody. And they're all in your life. So welcome to chaos. Am I the only one, or is people noticing this somewhere in your life? Chaos, just uncontrolled, no way. You know, if you could just control everybody in your world, give them each a lane, give them each a purpose, give them each what they'll do, how they'll treat each other, man, wouldn't life be good? But he says it's not going to happen. You can't control your world. He says there's nothing new under the sun. Despite all your efforts to reach and to do things, chaos, what people want to do, is going to happen. You're not going to control by yourself countries and accounts and whole, you know, business things. I mean, they don't make many carburetors anymore, so if that was your business and your career, that's been gone for a few decades. I mean, just whatever it is that we're trying to control. And it says that if you try, you're going to be subject to frustration. You're going to be frustrated all the time because there's nothing you can do under the sun. There's nothing you're going to change, nothing you're going to control. You know, many parents, it's about controlling their kids. It's not about training their children. It's about controlling their children. For many spouses, you know, you can smile and look real pretty. You can think you're the man, but until your marriage gets godlike, it's all about control. Control, control. And as you go through the book of Ecclesiastes, you're going to find that this is a depressing book because it has no answers except for the very last two verses, where it's not even the teacher, it's another person commenting on the book. And as you look at this, you'll find the New Testament tells us the same things. That when you go into the book of Romans and other books, it just starts to let us know that if you're walking in life, giving your life to Jesus because you think you're going to control people through prayer, control people through your actions, control people through whatever, you're in for one hell of an unhappy life. So what do we do as Christians? Do we, you know, just continue to try to control it and develop new techniques to control everything in our lives? Do we just submit to the chaos and the hell that goes on around us and what everyone would like to do to us? No. And this is not my topic. Skill development and developing abilities in all of these areas is different than trying to control people. Become a great spouse. Don't try to control yours. Become a great parent. Don't try just to control your kids. Develop skills. Teach skills. And there's some areas here that we'll touch on a little bit. But this desire to control people is literally an idol. It's you in your strength trying to control your world. And it doesn't work.